Through the open ocean. Perhaps there were originally two types of prey on the island before, but years of breeding combined them in one. Normally docile, Manta mobula is a carnivore only in that it naturally consumes plankton. Fortunately, Manta mobula is usually not aggressive, unless in fish. Its tail is incredibly sharp and can pierce through thick hide and armor with ease. While not the fastest swimmer around the island, Manta mobula is among the deadliest of small ocean mammals. Tribes who value striking power over speed often keep large schools of manta to ride. Its capability to briefly leap out of water provides it a showy tactic for avoiding combat as well. A quick jab through the heart of an unsuspecting survivor will easily take them by surprise. Thusly, many tribes use it as an escort for their slower cargo-carrying swimmers. Since it has no apparent use, all it does is remind him of the tribesmen who died seizing it from that giant spider. Can it really be useless, though? They described the artifacts that activated the obelisks as looking similar to it, so I headed to the nearest obelisk to see if I could get a response. No luck. Maybe it activates something else. Of course, the platform in the cave! It's a long shot, but it's the only thing I can think of that's similar to the obelisks. Definitely worth a try.
Thank you.
pretty unremarkable by the island standards, Oncorhynchus grexlamia is a generally passive fish. Its main form of protection is swimming in a large school. Oncorhynchus does not like conflict, and generally swims away from anything larger than itself at very high speeds. Once provoked, however, Oncorhynchus becomes quite aggressive, along with its nearby brethren. It locks onto its prey with its long saber teeth and begins draining the creature's blood. This loss of blood is not too dangerous alone, but when a school of Oncorhynchus attack at once, their target quickly loses speed and stamina from blood loss, drowning if it cannot breathe underwater. Like many of the smaller fish found on or around the island, Oncorhynchus cannot be tamed, but it is often herded and harvested for its resources. In particular, certain cuts of Oncorhynchus meat are considered to have superb quality and are often referred to as prime fish, used for specific high-end concoctions and taming the island's many piscivorous creatures.